This is Pastor Ngura again. Today we look at another section of Agape Love. We said it has four parts to it. It is pure, it's willful, it is sacrificial, and it is also universal. So today we look at the fact that Agape Love should be or is willful. Nobody should force you to love. Philippians chapter 2 and verse 3 says, "Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem the other better than themselves." So, agape love is not born just out of emotions, as I said earlier. Not out of emotion, not out of feelings, not out of familiarity, not out of attraction, but from a will. You choose. It's a choice you make. You choose to love God. You choose to love your neighbor. You choose to love even those that hate you. So, it's willful. The scripture just told us that let nothing be done through strife, not even by compulsion, but kind of naturally, you extend it to those, including those whom, according to you, do not deserve that kind of love. So, it's a commitment. As I said earlier, you choose and you commit yourself to love, even the difficult ones to love. So, it is sacrificial. We'll be touching on that shortly. And it doesn't expect anything in return. As I said again, many people love because of what they get. Cross check. Sometimes people are loving you. Some people are drawing close to you because of what they want to get. I have been to many places, many towns. Sometimes you find Bona, people call you and give you names. They will call you the rich man, Mugaga, Hajat, whatever. But it's not because they respect you. They're giving you those titles because of what they know you will give them. And sometimes, so that when it comes to negotiation, you're not difficult because after all, they're going to be giving you a big title. Boss. Welcome, boss. I'm happy to see you, boss. Come and see, boss. And that's so that then when it comes to the money side of it, you easily give it to them. So, agape love is done willfully. Nobody compels you to love. But if this compulsion, then it's coming from God himself. And not anything, not anyone else forcing you to love anyone because of what you want to get, because of what you want to gain. But you willfully, with that compulsion, love all. This is the love that God is calling us to have. And as I said earlier, God is the standard of this love. He loved us. What did we have? How right were we? You know, who are lost, who are enemies of the cross, and yet he still sent his son to die for us on the cross. He willfully, out of his own love, came looking for us and saved us. So, anytime you're struggling, anytime you feel compelled to love, then that's a different type of love. If it is because of what you're going to get or anything else, if it is not out of your personal will, if it's not coming from your heart, check, it could be a different type of love, not agape. And agape is the love, the sort of love that scripture teaches us and tells us to have and to extend to those around us. Thank you so much. I hope you will, from now on, be reminded to willfully. No compulsion. No policing around. Love those around you. Love everybody you come across. Not just relatives. Not just friends. Including non-believers. Willfully, out of what you know about the nature of God, love them and show them the right thing and give them whatever they need. Because God is love. Thank you so much, and may God bless you.